second fight of the night, bantamweight Muay Thai, 8'10" pound from America, Medizatoud from Algeria.
Yeah, this is gonna be interesting to see how Asa handles those small gloves. I know he's used to big gloves, but you know, Medizatoud's been here. He's been inside the circle. He's used to the bright lights. Nice two-piece.
Oh, nice combo to open up. First 30 seconds, this one. A little catch and a fire back there from Asa Tenpao. Look at that jab, judging the distance. Wild left hook there, didn't land. Straight right was nice. Wild head kick and a big shot on the counterattack from Zatoud.
Ace has got to be careful with some of these kicks and punches because he oftentimes will get himself out of position where he exposes his back to his opponent like that with a big technique.
These 1-2 combos to begin. Zatoud setting the tone early.
Yeah, Zatoud's got really clean boxing, man. Oh, he got caught right there by a left hand by Asa. Oh, and he answers back with a right hand of his own. Asa said that Medizatoud's got hands. That's his only weapon that he's got, but it's not even that good. So I think Medi really wants to put a beating on him with the hands.
It's an absolute firefight to begin. Oh, wild overhand right from Asa Tenpao.
You can already see that tattoo that Asa's got on the right side of his body from one of those big kicks landed by Zatoud. Now he's starting to taunt him. This is where Medi really starts to find his range and his timing. His hands come down, and he starts gunslinging from his hips.
Medi got the hands down. You're right. He's awfully confident in this opening round.
Yeah, it only took him about a minute and a half to figure out the timing and the rhythm of Asa.
Sends him flying back right there, Mitch.
Medi's got almost 10 times more experience than you know Asa, so he's really going to try to lean on that here.
It's that last technique that Asa threw that got him out of position again. What you don't understand is that it takes a lot longer to throw techniques like that. When you're against somebody like Medizatoud, he knows how to read every little micro movement that's coming in the body way before the technique actually gets there.
And you know, straight kick by Asa Tenpao, mixing it up there.
Yeah, you said that Medi's been focusing on the eyes, and you can just see that. His hands are down, and he's just looking for these slight little micro movements of Asa so he can figure out where he's coming from. And the hands are down at his hips. And he's just almost egging Asa to come forward and throw something so he can counter.
Alrighty, some damage underneath the left eye as well as the right side of the body there of Asa Tenpao, the American.
Good head movement so far early on. Are you surprised, Rich, by Medi going backwards as much as he is?
I am, only because Asa is typically a counter puncher, and I wouldn't expect him to pressure this much. I think it's a good idea that he's doing that. But if I were him, I would keep my feet on the ground a little bit more and depend on those boxing skills that we were discussing earlier.
Yeah, Asa's head hunting right now. Oh, he's popping the eye.
Yep, he's in trouble. Heavy knees in the clinch there, and now
Asa's
they separate.
Hurt. Asa's
down he goes. On the attack, Zatoud.
Oh. That could have been after the bell right there.
What a way to end the round. And look at the eye of Asa Tenpao. You were on it, Mitch. Dragon, you were on it. That left eye in trouble. And Zatoud is really feeling himself right now.
Yeah, man, he caught him. And that eye immediately gave Asa Tenpao some problems. I don't think he can open it. He might not be able to answer the bell. Let's take a look at this. See, that's that movement. Look at that nice little skip. Right there, boom. He started to fight. Oh, that one right there landed clean.
Dragging
on the left side of his face.
That right has been heavy so far in this fight.
Yeah, it's a hammer, and Medi throws it with some serious speed. Boop. Look at that, boom, right there. Immediately, Asa was like, oh no, this small gloves, these things hurt differently. Really the first time you get cracked with small gloves, your entire world changes. If you start to rethink your life choices.
Yeah. It's not just getting cracked with the small gloves, but realizing that you don't have as much space to cover on your defense, particularly with somebody like Asa.
That's it.
He cannot get off the stool, and the fight is over after one round. It's a TKO for that man on the top of the one circle, celebrating the veteran from Algeria. Gets it done here tonight in Malaysia. Medizatoud with an incredible 3 minutes of Muay Thai in the bantamweight division, putting on an early show on this incredible fight card tonight.
This was a great performance by Medizatoud. He showed a different kind of level, like how much higher of a level he is than Asa in this particular match, being able to time him, read his techniques from start to finish. He was just able to calculate it. This is the fin. This is the finishing shot right here. Satou comes over top, catches him with that right hand, and immediately you can see that Asa is injured here. Satou was wasting no time on this and wasn't going to take any chances without trying to finish this fight.
Let's be clear. It's tough to get off the stool. Asa Tenpal, obviously a tough guy, but that situation is tough. Here's Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Justin Brown, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes in the very first round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Maddie Zatoo!